technical experts and scientists in Chile's environmental history, for, especially with attention to the 1990s. The approach is historical and anthropological. It fits from two academic disciplines, science and policy technology studies and science and society studies. This work dialogues with scientific literature, especially with the theoretical approaches and international experiences, but anchored in professional trajectories, relations, and historical circumstances in our country. This is work in progress. The data is being constructed from multiple sources. However, there are two manuscripts resulting from scrutinizing initial data. The first one was an analysis of institutional work done by experts done by the first generation of environmental experts. It was written with Regina Masai and Mauricio Osses. There we identified some emerging patterns. For example, the kinds of institutional work performed by these experts and the process of becoming an expert. The second one resulted from developing a case study in a topic that was emerging as particularly important for the science policy relationships. It is the regulation of airborne arsenic. We studied it from a knowledge governance approach with Raul Ryan, who was part of the process, and with the historian Barbara Silva. There, the regulation took 10 years to be launched, and during the process, there was quite a big scientific effort involved, and also we could see how the technical experts from the public sectors was the one giving continuity to this long process. Well, I believe there is value in documenting our environmental history, and I think it can help to reflect on the relationships between science and policy in our country. There is also, of course, an instrumental value that, together with enthusiasm, some better understanding of policy decision making and environmental governance could help to have a more effective intervention and participation of science in the processes. That's it.